Hello there and welcome to this week's episode of Iron Pod. It's proudly brought to you by Westview Consulting, also Ghana Oil Company Limited and Ghana Community Network Services, GCNet. Folks, now this week there's a lot of joy for the platform because a number of the issues that you bring to us or bring to our attention is getting resolved. And if you recall last week, we told you about about 100 trucks that have been detained at the border of Ghana and Burkina Faso as well. Thanks to the government of Burkina Faso as well as the Ghana government, I can confidently tell you that all those trucks have been released and they have gone all the way to Ouagadougou to discharge their goods. That will be coming up shortly. In the meantime, let me also tell you that this issue of Audi Q7 we have been following on this platform belonging to one Mr. and Mrs. Hammond. Thanks to the Commissioner General of Ghana Revenue Authority, Mr. George Blankson, also the Commissioner of Customs, Mr. John Vianney Kudamnuru, we have good news. Mr. Peter Bakufan is engaging Mr. and Mrs. Hammond to ensure some compensation for these people. So they are already smiling, folks.
The Customs Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority, GRA, has begun negotiation processes to compensate Jonathan and Olivia Hammond, a US-based couple, following the seizure and subsequent allocation of their Audi Q7 they imported into Ghana on 23rd July 2014. The couple, it will be recalled, wrote several petitions to the Commissioner of Customs lamenting the circumstances under which their Audi Q7 was seized and subsequently allocated to one Loretta Asari. Iron Port began intense investigations into the matter. The Ministry of Trade and Industry advised the couple to go to court if they felt unsatisfied with services rendered them by customs.
It's a very serious allegation, and that is why I would expect the person involved to have gone to court.
The Commissioner General of Ghana Revenue Authority intervened and requested the Commissioner of Customs to investigate and resolve the matter. It was eventually revealed, although the couple did not meet their deadlines to make payments, customs processed equally hard challenges, as was admitted by customs itself to Iron Port.
These are two documents coming out of customs.
Yes.
And in fact, a year or so ago, we had almost cleaned up this.
Yeah.
It didn't used to occur. But now that it has occurred, we will have to sit down, like I said, and ensure that it's cleaned up. And this thing did not happen.
However, in a move to bring closure to the matter, the Hammonds were on Thursday, 28 April 2016, invited by Customs. Customs Committee handling the matter, chaired by Peter Bakufan, proposed to compensate the couple for the inconvenience.
Gave us their options, the options that through which they're going to resolve this matter. And we also gave them what we think should have been the best thing to do to put an end to this whole thing once and for all. Having said that, their option, I can still say that if only they're going to keep their promise as they said, then I think on gradual basis we might get to the end of this problem.
It should, however, be noted that Customs is not compensating the couple because they were entirely right in the matter, but also Customs had admitted some documentation challenges from their end. The couple, however, is pleased with the compensation package being proposed by Customs and have requested for it to be documented.
We will want everything to be written on paper because reshuffles happens here and there. What if the person who gave us this assurance is transferred or removed? Move from his office, the next person coming, everything is going to be new to him.
It will be recalled that Iron Port brought viewers the story of a US-based Ghanaian, Jonathan Hammond, and his wife Olivia Hammond, who were grieving over the seizure and allocation of their Audi Q7 car to an unknown person, allegedly by customs and members of the Vehicle Allocation Committee at the Flagstaff House. According to them, some officials of customs prevented them from paying the duties on the Audi Q7 the very last day a privilege given to them was going to expire. They said several petitions written to the Commissioner of the Customs Division of the Ghana Revenue Authority to retrieve their Audi Q7 car had proved futile. Jonathan Hammond said he imported four cars, including an Audi Q7 from New York, but he was only allowed to clear three of the cars.
Well, so Mr. and Mrs. Hammond, they're already smiling because they know there is a bright light at the end of the tunnel, thanks to the men and women who have made this possible, particularly the Commissioner General of Ghana Revenue Authority, also the Commissioner of Customs, and Mr. Peter Bakufan, and the entire custom team. We thank you and salute you for negotiating to get some compensation of a sort for this couple. In the meantime, we brought you a story of the detained trucks at the Paga border. They have been released.
The government of Burkina Faso, through its Ministry of Transport, has suspended the implementation of a decree that enforced strict implementation of a loading permit called bon de chargement, and has therefore released documents of about 100 trucks to their drivers to allow them enter Burkina Faso and offload their cargo. The Burkinabe government has also suspended the strict implementation of the bon de chargement. This means that from now, any truck driver who takes cargo from Ghana to Burkina Faso may possess the bon de chargement or not, but will still be allowed into the country. The move by the Burkinabe government came few hours after a delegation from Ghana, led by the Deputy Transport Minister, Joyce Bawa Mukhtar, and comprising officials from Ghana's embassy in Burkina Faso, led by the ambassador, officials from Ghana Shippers Authority and Ghana Ports and Harbors Authority, called on the Burkina Faso government in that country's capital, Ouagadougou. Ghana's Deputy Minister of Transport, Joyce Bawa Mukhtari, did not mince words to express Ghana's disappointment in the Burkinabe government's release of a decree intended to affect the trade between the two countries, and yet did not consult Ghana.
You can only appeal to us to find ways to assist you to address it, but I don't think you can expect us to help you enforce legislation on any citizens. It is good to help our business people. Yes, there's nothing wrong with that. But protectionism to a certain extent, another person's jurisdiction, is unacceptable as a business practice.
The deputy minister and the team also visited Waga Inter, Dakola, and the Paga borders, places where most of the Ghanaian truck drivers had gathered to interact with them.
But the secret is for you not to give up.
Sanity.
The deputy minister personally gave the drivers $2,000 to support them.
Thank you. Minister, sir.
She also called on the president of Burkina Faso to request his intervention and met with Burkinabe importers, which unfortunately led to a row when a Burkinabe businessman spoke against the implementation of the bon de chargement. Few hours after the deputy minister's intervention, the government of Burkina Faso has released the documents of all the trucks that were held up at the border while an amicable solution is being sought for the implementation of the bon de chargement.
We had a certain understanding with our counterparts in Burkina Faso, and one of the major issues that we agreed upon was the fact that the detained drivers must be released with their documents given to them. And I'm happy to inform you that they've all been released and their documents released to them.
Both the government of Ghana and that of Burkina Faso charged the shippers authorities of both countries to produce a blueprint on harmonizing the transit trade to Burkina Faso on the Ghanaian transit corridor.
For now, we have called for the suspension of whatever directive they have, you know, until we agree on the modalities of their of managing of their transit cargo from here to Burkina Faso.
Also, Mr. and Mrs. Hammond are smiling. The truck drivers are also smiling. And that's what you get if you follow this program, Eye on Port. Always get in touch with us if you have any challenge dealing with the port. We will endeavor to share them with the rest of the world. And also pursue to see if, God willing, there can be a bright light at the end of the tunnel. But you are also required to do the right thing. Get to know the procedures for clearing your goods at the port. We always advise that even 21 days before you bring in your goods, please begin the processes, and you will always be smiling dealing with the ports of Ghana. Iron Port returns after the break.
I gotta slow down.
Every time you think of importing goods into Ghana, know that there is a competent team of world-class personnel to cater to your trade needs. Know that there is a help desk you can call with your queries. Know that you can speed up the process of clearing your goods with customs long before they arrive in Ghana. Remember that CCVR which used to take several days, now only takes 48 hours through the new Customs Pre-Arrival Assessment Reporting System known as PAS. Remember that our staff all over the nation is waiting to serve you. Remember that PAS makes imports into Ghana faster, simpler, safer, and easier. Ghana Revenue Authority, committed to serving you better.
Ghana's goil.
Your own goil.
Our own goil.
Ghana's goil. Goil, goil, in the service of the nation. North, south, east, and west, wherever we put you first. Goil, goil, goil is good energy. Goil is good energy. Services so friendly.
Next up, news and activities happening in and around the ports.
Meanwhile, custom officers and truckers at the Ghana border town of Paga in the Upper East region are appealing to stakeholder agencies to come to their rescue to pave the parking yard for the transit trucks at Ghana's borders with Burkina Faso.
It has been like this ever since I came here more than 10 years ago. And year in, year out, we have to do filling, get gravels, stones, and do fillings. As the cars come in, it develops big potholes, and we have to mobilize, get the little resources that we have to do the filling.
The transit yard, which hosts thousands of trucks carrying cargo and transiting into Burkina Faso on daily basis, always gets very dusty in the dry season and heavily muddy in the rainy season.
Dry season is dusty, rainy season is very muddy. So we have a big challenge. And most of the times, even the agents here, when you come and you see them, you will not believe they are agents. So most of the times, people refer to them as Goro boys. They are not Goro boys. They are agents. But just because of the nature of the park, the dressing is a problem.
Emmanuel Lawson said any effort that will be made to pave the transit parking yard, just as it has been done in the Tema port, will go a long way to grow Ghana's transit trade and keep officers motivated.
Reconstruction of the place, expansion, because we agree with me that volume of trade is increasing. Year in, year out, the volume of trade is increasing. So we should do something about it.
A delegation from the International Monetary Fund, IMF, has paid a familiarization visit to the offices of the Ghana Revenue Authority, GRA, Customs Division, and their technical partners, Westblue Consulting, to abreast themselves on the Ghana National Single Window Project currently being undertaken by Customs and Westblue.
How many, you know, corrections you make? I mean,
corrections.
Do you think that the valuation was not right?
There is quite significant,
uh-huh.
And that is understandable based on the fact that our system, the customs clearing agents, in terms of their professional development, they are not that up to speed.
Okay.
So most of the errors emanate from them, and we do part of the correction process.
Okay.
Though it appears that the learning process, they are descending the learning curve, so it's improving.
The delegation was briefed on the smooth transition of the responsibilities of classification, valuation, and risk management from the destination inspection company to customs with technical support from Westblue Consulting.
When were all these officers trained?
With, as part of the rollout process,
mm-hmm.
you know, before 1st September,
yeah.
there was an extensive training program.
Mm-hmm.
But even on our own, we have been doing capacity building on our
yeah.
own.
Mm-hmm.
We have been training officers. And Most of these officers are quite experienced in these matters, even before this one was set up.
The Chief Revenue Officer, Customs Technical Services Bureau, who received the IMF team, said the takeover from the DICs partly contributed to the achievement of GRA target last year.
Did you see an improvement in revenue collections?
Absolutely. There has been a remarkable improvement.
This year we're able to achieve our target.
We exceeded our target. And normally that is the measure that, and I think it's the same measure that you people are interested in. So once we exceed our target, but of course there are a gamut of reasons why we exceed our targets, but clearly this also impacted that process.
The project manager of West Blue said the National Single Window Project has brought relief to stakeholders in the clearance chain.
This is what we are trying to achieve at the end of the day. To establish a national single window for Ghana where all trade-related documents are submitted once, and that same information is shared with all the partners, is processed, and through that single entry point, you get all your trade regulatory documents back from it.
The IMF delegation pledged their support to make the Ghana National Single Window Project a success. As part of efforts to save time and cost to importers, West Blue Consulting has rolled out a banking module of the Pre-Arrival Assessment Reporting System, PAS, which is expected to give banks the opportunity to have access to declarations submitted by declarants. The facility is expected to increase compliance of both the banks and importers, as well as ensure transparency.
This aspect we are looking at today is on the banking module on PAS, whereby all the transaction or all data entered by the declarant on behalf of their importers, the bank also will have access to those data, and they can compare the information they have on the applications prior to transferring or fund on behalf of their client.
The module is also expected to increase government's revenue. Meanwhile, following several complaints by declarants which border on poor services by the help desk at the Customs Technical Service Bureau, the West Blue Consultant Limited has organized a customer service training program for customs officers to inculcate best practices and modern ways of serving customers in the offices. The Customs Technical Service Bureau is a very important part of the Ghana National Single Window Project because it is the first point of contact between customs and declarants with regards to clarification on services offered in the pre-arrival assessment system platform.
At the end of this training, we expect that we'll no longer hear of this complaint. One, declarants are assured of better services from the personnel at the Customs Technical Service Bureau help desk. Their inquiries and questions will be better handled, and they are guaranteed of more efficient services.
As part of moves to automate the Port of Tema, the Port Authority will very soon be launching an electronic vessel booking system, which is meant to cut down the processing time of allocation of space in the port for vessels belonging to shipping lines to berth. Hitherto, the process of allocating vessels to shipping lines were being done through daily berthing meetings, which brought all stakeholders together before spaces in the port were allocated to vessels to berth. It also took between 3 to 4 days for the bookings of space for vessels to be approved. However, with the introduction of the online electronic vessel booking system, shipping lines and their agents can book spaces for their vessels within 24 hours at their own convenience online, wherever they may be.
This service is going to help our clients by cutting down the time they spend visiting the ports, chasing stuff with paperwork to have service provided. This is electronic. It is real time, it is fast. So it is instant service that we are providing to our client.
In order to achieve a smooth implementation of the electronic online vessel booking system, a training session has been organized by the Port Authority to educate shipping lines and their agents on the impending electronic vessel booking systems.
We believe that this new system will help the shipping lines in cutting the time and the cost of doing business. They do not need to send an agent. With transport calls, with traffic and all that, they can sit anywhere to do booking.
The e-vessel booking system is expected to make it easier for shipping lines to apply for berthing arrangement through the website of the Ghana Port and Harbors Authority.
You can work anywhere you are through your iPad, through your Galaxy, through your mobile, through your desktop computer. Anywhere you are, once you have internet, you should be able to.
Yeah! Yeah!
Over 40 security personnel at the port of Tema have undergone a two-month intensive physical training to boost their morale in the discharge of their duties at the port. The training was also meant to equip them with the requisite skills to enable them to protect cargo, properties and people who do business in and around the port. The training manager of GPHA entreated the personnel to use their newly acquired knowledge to serve the port authority and the nation at large.
When someone is attacking you, he's not mindful of such a situation. Therefore, the training is to equip you so that just in case there's an attack.
The training will allow the port security personnel to defend themselves without using weapons anytime the situation demands it. The capacity of the port of Takoradi to handle all kinds of vehicles that enter the port has been boosted with the construction of a car terminal by Save Bond Company Limited. When completed, the facility, which will be sitting on a 4-acre land, will accommodate 3,500 various types of vehicles at a time. The facility is also located outside the port of Takoradi to make space for the massive expansion works being undertaken at the port.
We're receiving lots and lots of new businesses in the port, and we need to free the port space for other urgent or essential businesses. And one of these is to move such activities that we are doing at back, like receiving vehicles inside the port to an off-dock terminal like this one, so that we can make way for other businesses that are coming in.
Collins Opon Asante, the Save Bond Company Limited Terminal Manager in Takoradi, said the facility will start receiving vehicles from May this year.
Currently, we have installed electric fencing around the walls, and we intend to provide security towers. And then we also we have contracted a company to give us CCTV cameras all around. And then we also have the human severance, floodlights, advantage points, which will all augment to provide safe security over here.
He said the facility will make the clearance of cars at the port less cumbersome and assured of total security within the facility. Management of Takoradi Port believe the facility, when completed, will be a one-stop shop for potential customers who will be coming for their vehicles in the port.
There will be ease of clearance in the port. People will not spend much time around. Once the car is cleared from the port, it is driven here. You come here, once the duties and everything are paid, you come here, it's facilitated within the shortest possible time.
Ghana Oil Company Limited, GOIL, a leading oil and gas brand and the most successful indigenous oil marketing company in Ghana, is promising to offer existing shareholders lower shareholding prices in the form of what it calls right issue. The idea of reducing the shareholding prices for the existing shareholders is to allow them purchase more shares in GOIL, which is currently trading well on the stock market. GOIL aims to raise additional 155 million Ghana cedis funds for the company through the reduction of share price for already existing shareholders. And to achieve this, GOIL is said to reduce the price per share of each existing shareholder to 1.24 Ghana cedis from the current closing price of 1.46 per share as at 21st March 2016, which is a discount of 15% per share for each existing shareholder.
What it means is that you are getting the right shares at a price which is lower than the market price.
Ghana Oil Company Limited, GOIL, at the moment remains the only indigenous oil marketing company that offer bunkering services to fuel all vessels with marine gas oil at the port of Ghana, both in Takoradi and Tema. The managing director of GOIL, Patrick Akoli, said proceeds from the new offer will be used to strengthen the company's balance sheet, expand the current retail outlets, as well as acquire a lubricant blending plant.
And this is the time that GOIL has to expand. You know, we are doing a lot of projects. We are expanding our retail outlets. We move our retail outlets from 165 3 years ago to 256 as I speak today. We are doing investments in the banking sector. You go to Takoradi, you go to Sekendi, you see projects coming up. We want to go into the bitumen storage facility. because all the major roads that are being done in Ghana now, the bitumen are being imported.
At a stakeholders forum to brief all stakeholders of GOIL on the upcoming right issue, Patrick Akoli emphasized that GOIL is undertaking a number of significant projects, which include the establishment of a new bunkering facility at the Takwadi port to allow all vessels fueled when they call the port. Hence, all monies realized from the right issue offer will go a long way to reduce the debt of the company.
The company is relying more on debt capital to finance its projects. So it is good for equity shareholders who are the owners of the company to also inject some funds. By so doing, it to expand the shareholder base, the shareholders fund base of the of the balance sheet, and attract more investors so that this company can expand and do things more quickly than we are even doing now.
In a related development, GOIL has presented a sponsorship package of 480,000 Ghana cedis each to two local clubs, Kumasi Asante Kotoko and Accra Hasafok, as part of the company's drive to develop local football in the country.
So we think there's a need to start helping the local league, and by so doing, helping some of the current problems in society. GOIL is there to support the local economy. If we make us big, we also do what bigger things.
GOIL hopes to continue to support all facets of the Ghanaian life if all Ghanaians will tend to consume its quality products in the market.
I gotta slow down. Every time you think of importing goods into Ghana, know that there is a competent team of world-class personnel to cater to your trade needs. Know that there is a help desk you can call with your queries. Know that you can speed up the process of clearing your goods with customs long before they arrive in Ghana. Remember that CCVR, which used to take several days, now only takes 48 hours through the new Customs Pre-Arrival Assessment Reporting System known as PAS. Remember that our staff all over the nation is waiting to serve you. Remember that PAS makes imports into Ghana faster, simpler, safer, and easier. Ghana Revenue Authority, committed to serving you better.
Ghana's GOIL.
Your own GOIL. Our own GOIL. But if you want to be a GOIL, you can't be a GOIL. You can't be a GOIL.
GOIL is virtually in every corner of the country, and therefore, in terms of reaching out to every nook and creek of this country, they are there to serve the population. They are fishing communities, they are in farming communities in the hinterland. We think that they are a strategic asset to the country.
Good energy and a moya de munya. Nefri himfa, nefri
GOIL.
Schedules of vessels in the port, those at Anchorage, and also those expected for the coming week next. Well, this week we're getting a number of comments from you, and one of them includes a fellow who is also reporting of his missing Nissan 2.5 liter. He said he sent it all the way from Ontario in Canada, but he can't find it in Ghana.
I shipped my Nissan Maxima 3.5 from Toronto, Ontario, to Ghana, July 20th, 2015. And I came down right now, I can't find the car.
We'll be delving into that story in the coming editions of Eye on Port. Thank you for watching in the meantime. And also thanks to the entire crew, Robert Nyantechi, always the big man behind the camera. Also Godwin Kabute, Solomon Anderson, Joe Lavo, Ebenezer Tewia, and the executive producers, Paul Asariansan, as well as Abna Sewa Opoku Fosu. Kunedu Yadom supported the program as well. Thank you for watching.